After a lot of trials and errors, I finally learned how to flash a Debian Linux to this Chipsee RK3568 PC. I am myself a macOS guy and I really don't like programming on Windows. I tried a lot of times to flash this device using macOS. I was able to compile RK develop tool. I was able to connect to and write to the MMC, but I break it. It shows a black screen and won't boot. No matter how I try and look for the resources on Google, I just can't get it back. So I unwillingly turned my Windows workstation and finally saved this Chipsee 7-inch Rockchip PC. Guys, I'm gonna tell you it's a lot easier to flash OS in Windows. Maybe I'm just the terrible Mac user who has been using macOS and Linux for 8 years. But it's just my experience with this Rockchip product and the tools. If I manage to flash in my Mac in the future, I will let you know in the comments below. So, let me tell you how to flash a Debian system to this little PC. This is the 7-inch Chipsee RK3568 touchpad PC we'll be using. This little thing came to me with a pre-installed Android 11. I did enjoy watching Jellyfin videos on the screen. It has a nice speaker and a powerful 4K decoding ability, but I decided to build a small project on it and I don't know how to write Android APKs. So I decided to move back to my comfort zone where I can write Python, I can have the browser, I can have the Linux ecosystem. I was planning to write an air quality measurement tool to keep track of the PM2.5 in the room on this device. If you feel like watching it, don't forget to subscribe. Let's plug in the USB cable on the Chipsee PC side. It's a USB Type-C port. On your workstation side, it can be USB-A or USB-C. Be sure to use a proper cable or it might disconnect halfway and break your device, like this. You hear that sound? It's indicating the USB cable is not connected stably. I found my PC's USB 2 port on the front panel has a lot of issues and a cheap Type-C cable also bugged me a lot. Let's plug in the Type-C cable to the device. When I was recording, the driver has been uninstalled intentionally. I just want to show you what it's like to flash OS without a proper driver. See, there is a new universal serial bus device, RK3XXX. Okay, now I will follow a Chipsee online dog to click the switch button. Hopefully the device should turn into a loader device. So, switch rock USB start. Wait a minute. Black screen, switch rock USB success. And it turns to a wallpaper. I don't know what it is, but I'm certain it's in a certain mode that's waiting for something. And in the Windows Device Manager, we can find this unknown USB download gadget. This should be our device because we have turned the device into loader mode. And because we don't have a proper driver, Windows cannot recognize it. So be sure to install a up-to-date driver. Let's go to driver assistant, click install driver. The current version is 5.1.1 at June 24th, 2023. If you come to this video from the future, check the most recent doc on Chipsee's website. Windows still cannot recognize it. Let's unplug and plug back the USB cable. And Windows can detect the device now. You can see there is a rock USB device because this device is already turned into loader mode. Normally, unlike me, if you install the driver assistant first, it should appear as an Android device with a nice looking icon in the Windows Device Manager and appear as an ADB device in RK Dev tool. That way you wouldn't have to replug the USB cable as I did. I will show you later. Okay, now let's get back to the RK Dev tool and see what we can do. My device is already in the loader mode. Normally yours should be in the ADB device mode. And let's click some buttons like refresh. And I would click this erase all button to erase everything in the MMC. So let's choose the firmware I downloaded from Chipsee website and upgrade. As the flashing goes, let me show you the proper way to flash this device. So before you switch to loader mode, you should install the driver assistant first, and then you open RK DevTool, it should say found one ADB device. Then you click switch. After 5 seconds, you should see found one loader device. And now you choose the Chipsee pre-built Debian image and click upgrade. The downloading process takes maybe 2 minutes. Let me just fast forward a little bit for you. Now the progress is 99-100%. The device goes black screen, it's a good sign, maybe it's automatically restarting. Then I could hear Windows USB device connect and disconnect sound multiple times and see there's a Android device in the tree. From now on, let's move the camera to our device and wait for the Debian to boot up. Okay, I can see a mouse now, good sign. Let's get closer for you to watch. This thing has a metal case, it's a little bit heavy. I've just put it down. Wait a little bit time, I cut some frames in the video. You should wait a few seconds longer and now I think we are good to go. Does the touchscreen gesture work? Let's have a try, it looks fine, better than I think. And now I think we can unplug the cable now. So after many trials and errors, I finally managed to flash an OS, even if it's in Windows. And my favorite workstation is a Mac. Anyway, don't forget to subscribe.